everybody, it's HoppingHammy here. I'm so excited to be doing a video room tour because I've had a lot of requests for that. So this is sort of my first time doing this, if you can bear with me. And also I want to say that I don't mean to make anyone feel bad or anything like that. God's really blessed me and I'm thankful for that. And also a lot of the stuff that you see in the room we got for sort of like really good deals. So it's not like we had to pay a ton of money or anything like that to decorate. So I hope that you enjoy this and let's get started. So as you can see, this is standing outside the door. There's a mirror. And then I have this little cute bird and two flowers and this punchy doodad on the doorknob. So here we go. This is a general view of the room as you walk in. We can see all the stickers on the ceiling that took like a whole day. Yay! Took forever. Here are Yodel's cages. And I'll show you more about that here in a minute. Let's start behind the door, which I have my hoodie that I just hang up. And then stickers down here on the bottom. If you turn over here, I have the cute little wall sticker that says hi and a nightlight. It's a flower nightlight. And then my two favorite tote bags in the entire world. One has a hamster, as you can see, and the other one has a heart. And I love them. I wear them like all the time. Or not wear them, but use them, you know. This is a cute little hamster change purse. It says I'm a little short. And sometimes I use it, but I don't want to wreck it. So most of the time I just like display it. We have my lovely bulletin board. As you can see, those are all pictures of my past hamsters. And I don't have Yodel or Baklava up yet because I ran out of ink like, I don't know, 6 months ago. So yeah, I'll eventually put the pictures up and add them with the rest. And then that was me like, I don't know, 5 years ago with my dog Tootsie Roll. And yeah, just cute little things. And it says, hi, Hamster Hideout and YouTube. So I would like to give a couple of quick shout outs. First of all, Chocolate Colors 26, she is a really funny and really awesome girl. I love talking to her. She has a channel, and she does really awesome videos with lots of information for hamsters, dogs, cats, and she really knows her stuff. So please do go subscribe to her. She's super nice, and she totally deserves it. Secondly, Funny Pics... Fuzzy Pixie 16. She's one of my very close friends and she's so awesome. She has a lot of hamster videos and they're so funny, like, I don't know, they're just so funny. And she has a hamster named Smee, which is super cute, and one of these days I'm gonna steal him. And lastly, there's Azales or Azales, however you so choose to pronounce it. I say Azales, but yeah, whatever. He doesn't do a ton of videos, but I think he'll probably be getting more into it in the future, and his intro is really awesome. He did this stop motion thing, and he also does the best project logs. So be sure to subscribe to him, and you're sure to learn a whole ton of information that you didn't know. That's my talking hamster birthday card. This says, God loves the real you, which I love that. I think that's so cool. And then just a thank you card that somebody gave me. So we're going to proceed to my closet bed. I'm going to stand back a little ways to give you sort of an overview of it here. I have that lovely ice cream cone punchy throw. And by the way, punchy, which you can see punchy up here. Punchy is... a term that I use for anything that's like super colorful and bright and happy. So this is called the punchy room. And you can see there are curtains. It's super duper cozy in the closet bed. I love sitting in there. So on the right side we have a Himalayan salt rock lamp. That's like a nightlight that I use. It's really nice. and some vanilla icing, body lotion, tissue box. On the shelf below, that's where I keep my laptop. So I can check Hamster Hideout like the very second that I wake up in the morning. No, seriously, it's true. And then there's my journal in that little cubby thing down there. I write about people. No, I'm just kidding. Okay. Then I have this desk lamp if I want more light for reading, and a clock which doesn't actually show the real time right now. I actually switched it up just to be funny so that nobody could guess like what time it is. Yeah. So, okay, and then down here is this little cardboard doghouse that my mom made years and years ago. It says Sniff on it, and inside is Sniff, which is a little stuffed dog, and then he has a friend named Ollie. And I've had them for like so many years, I'm not even going to say because it'll give away my age, but so I can't part with them, so they sleep in that little doghouse. There's socks, like extra socks in that drawer. And let's see. Oh yeah, I have magazines and markers down in the bottom. So, okay, here is the fun part. Yay, we get to look at hamster cages. As you can see, there's more stickers on the wall. And when I built these cages, I had it in mind to have one Syrian and one dwarf. But right now, I just want to have one hamster, I think. So Yodel actually is going to get, he has all of these cages that you see right here. We have the oboes over here. And inside the drawers, I just have clothes, lots and lots of punchy socks. ouch. This one just has jeans and shorts. I know, it's kind of boring. Okay, so this tube goes all the way back here and loops around, and it goes either up, you can go right, or you can go left, or you can go down. And this is my absolute favorite part of the entire room, believe it or not. This DIY cage that I made a year ago or something. It was a lot of work and it kind of cost a lot, but I'm really, really happy with it. And I'll be able to have it for years to come. I like the fact that it's open also, and it has, I don't have to mess with the cover every time I want to do anything in it. So I'll give you a real quick tour. You can basically see what he has in it. He has this food dish up here. I put it up here because he's really funny and he likes to kick shavings into it, so it gets a little bit annoying to have to dig the shavings out. He has this cheeseburger, which he completely ignores, but that's okay. It looks cute anyway. And he's really super duper spoiled. He has the giant flying saucer wheel and the comfort wheel. And it's so funny at night, he likes to go back and forth between the two of them, so I just leave both of them in there for him. And you can see Yodel, he's in his little strawberry house, oops, which he always sleeps in there. It's so cute. He loves his little house. So, moving along. Again, we follow this tube that's in the back here, and it goes all the way over here. And it's a mirror image of the other side with the file cabinets. So, yeah, he has all of that. And he doesn't pee in the tubes, thank goodness. But sometimes he chews in them, which is kind of annoying. okay, this drawer is really fun. Here's where I keep extra hamster supplies. And usually I switch them out probably every 3 days or so. Just to keep him occupied so he doesn't get too naughty and bored. And this drawer is actually really clean right now. It's usually, has shavings all over the place. And then here's the second one. There's Puzzle Playgrounds, gloves. Here's a little pin that I use when I want to, take like a bitey hamster out. I don't use it right now, but. And masks, which are extremely important when cleaning out lots of turds. let's see. Yeah, just pretty self-explanatory. Dustpan, Yeah, so again, like I was saying, when I built this, I made it, it was supposed to be for a dwarf hamster, so over here there was this cube, and the tube actually attached to the cube, so yeah, he doesn't have it, because Critter Trail's tubes are too small, so I just detached that for now. But anyway, it goes all the way down, sorry, and more stickers on the wall. And the tube comes around to this Critter Trail outlook, and it's pretty bare right now since I don't even have a hamster in it, but I just put toys in anyway. It goes up here to this Critter Trail pink cage, which is really pretty. And then on the top shelf I have this lovely pink lamp and just random hamster pictures I found online that are really cute. And then ice cream cone bubbles. And you can see my curtains behind there too. Okay, moving along. This butterfly hanging thing in the corner is really cool. I like that. And then I have this lamp and three bins which have supplies. As you can see, the tubes continue on from that cage, and there's stickers that say tubes. And it goes all the way around the bin and over to these other cages. So inside the bin I have, the bottom one has a travel cage and aquarium covers. And then this one has Carefresh color bedding. And this one has just Aspen, which it sort of takes almost that whole bin. I think that's a 64 quart to fill Yodel's DIY cage. So yeah, it takes a lot of bedding. And the tubes go over here to this Critter Trail Mini. And it also goes up to this Ovo cage. Up on this shelf, I just have a puzzle. And you might recognize that dish from Yodel's photo shoot. And this is one of my favorite shelves. It's the hamster shelf, as you can see. A friend, all these little hamster figurines that you see, a friend sent from Hamster Hideout, and I'm not going to say who she is to embarrass her, but I'm so grateful for that because they don't sell those anywhere around here, and they're so super cute. They have, this is a Chinese hamster. Let's see if I can get it to focus. There we go. See, that's a Chinese hamster. They have golden hamster, Campbell's, there's Roborovsky. So yeah, I love those. And then just this paper hamster I made, and this is a Happy Meal toy. Three tissue packs, which I probably will never use because they're way too cute, and I can't bear to ruin the packaging. okay. So up here, there's Critter Trail, like, bubble caps and Ovo connectors, extras that I don't need, or that I'm not using. And this one, let me show you what's in here. This one just has lots of really cute, fun stuff that my friend sent me. It has stickers, and yeah, see, we have hamster stickers and heart stickers. It's so much fun. This is a Hello Kitty coloring that I think I've done three so far. Yep. And just random cute things in there. Okay, so in between these two bookcases is this little cubby thing. There's an owl on the top, which I thought was fun, and this is a photo of my dog Tootsie Roll, which I don't have her anymore. She had to be put to sleep last January, but I loved her so much. Inside of this cupboard is where I keep all of my hamster food. There's oats. Those are sesame seeds. Lentils, which I'm not really giving that many at the moment. I'm not sure if they're safe or not. And then flax seeds and wheat germ. And this is my hamster food container. This actually has Hello Kitty candy, which I eat, not the hamster, obviously. And then this up here has different types of chews, cheesy chews, seagrass, sticks, mineral chews. Yeah, so those are just extras. And then this is a container of millet seed, which Yodel actually will not touch, so that's kind of annoying. And so, okay, so these tubes, remember the cages over here? So the tubes go behind this trash can and up like that. And okay, mup, just so that you know what mup is. I don't know what it is actually, but it's something that it sounds like this. Okay, so it's sort of like an inside joke with my family. I have no idea what it is, but it's funny anyway. So there you have it. Okay, so the tubes go over here to this final cage that's supposed to be, again, for the dwarf. So it was starting way at the other side, and then it looped around the room, and it ends over here. This next shelf is my collection of hamster books, and I have some dog and aquarium books as well. This digital thermometer is super duper handy to have because I can tell, like especially in the winter, to make sure it doesn't get too cold in here. And this tissue box has mice on it, which is super cute. Okay, this next shelf I have these two plush dachshunds that my friend's mom hand sewed for me that are so cute. And pads of paper. And then I love this shelf. Again, she, the same friend, drew this drawing of Cream Puff, which was a past hamster, and it turned out really nice. And then this little Cream Puff felt plushie is super cute. This is a craft shelf that I painted myself. And I just put the little hamster erasers and toys and whatnot on it. It's so cute. And lastly, these two tubs up here have extra critter trail tube attachments, and they're divided by color, as you can see, because I'm like funny like that. So that's pretty much it. My battery's running out here. Over here, more stickers on the wall that say fun. And the Happy Flower Family. So lastly, I have a few more supplies in drawers that are in my other room across the house. I don't have room for them in here, so I'm going to walk over real fast. I have 4 minutes left on my battery, and I will show those to you. Okay, here we go. Okay, here we are in my other room. It's just decorated Victorian, and it's sort of just a spare room right now. We used to have all of this stuff in my bedroom, which is now the hamster room. I will do a video tour of this room probably at Christmas because I'll have it decorated. So anyway, there's 6 drawers in here, and I'm just keeping my hamster supplies in it. Those are tubes and popsicle sticks. These are extra wheels. One day when I have a pair of dwarfs, I'd like to have multiple wheels. At this moment, I am not ready for a pair yet, so I just keep the extras in here. And this last drawer has water bottles, food dishes, this aquarium cover, and yeah, stuff like that. This one has more plastic supplies. These are just all cardboard boxes, and I have a tea box, as you can see. And this last drawer has more tubes. So anyway, I have 1 minute left, and I need to go before my battery runs out, but I hope that you enjoyed this video, and there will be more in the future. Bye!